Hey, what's up, guys? Brent here. Thank you so much for tuning into this devotional. Hope you guys had a wonderful Thanksgiving. Hope you guys ate a lot of turkey, had a lot of good food, enjoyed the time off with your friends and your family. Super thankful for this cosplay community, for my team here at Cosplay for Christ, and of course, our friend Kevin Barnett, who wrote this awesome devotional. You guys have probably heard about it. It's What's Your True Identity, a Superhero Devotional. It's the devotional that we're using for these videos. So if you guys have not yet gotten that book, please do. It makes a really good Black Friday present and or a really good Christmas gift. And I know that Kevin would thank you guys in advance. But aside from that, Hawkeye just got released on Disney Plus, first two episodes, really quick. I'm not gonna put any spoilers out there, but in the trailer that many of you guys have seen, there's this little musical thing, right? Well, I don't know if you guys know, but we at Cosplay for Christ, about a couple of years ago, we did a musical. So if you love cringe, you can always watch our video. I'll link it somewhere here or there, description or a card, something like that. So if you think if you've seen Hawkeye, if you thought that was cringy, well, we beat Mickey Mouse in the cringe department. And our musical has three songs compared to just that one song in the TV series. So we will be talking about Hawkeye today. Perfect timing, man. You know how God sets things up. So we're going to be talking about Hawkeye. We're going to be talking about hitting the mark. Archery, right? There's a term called sin that means to miss the mark. It means to not hit the bullseye or not hit the target or what you're aiming at. In Christianity, sin is anything that you do, think, or say that goes against God or that does not please God. So we know that Hawkeye is perfect when he has a bow in his hands. He's able to hit a target. He's able to hit it 100% of the time. He is a marvelous archer. But we also know that Hawkeye doesn't have great moments either, right? So guys, remember when Loki brainwashed him or when he got tripped up by Quicksilver, right? And there are times when Hawkeye fights where he feels underpowered compared to everyone else, right? He has a bow and arrow. He's more of a street level type fighter, right? He doesn't have magic. He doesn't have super strength, super speed. He can't fly. He can't read minds, right? He's not wearing invincible armor. So he does get hurt. He does get thrown around in battle, right? His arrows at times look like they're really not doing anything, even though some of his arrows can explode upon impact, things like that. His arrows won't be taking down someone like Thor anytime soon, right? But here's the thing. When we talk about our Christian life and following Jesus, that's exactly how the enemy comes after us, right? The devil will cause us to miss the mark. And he'll use two things. He'll use distraction and he'll use deception, right? The enemy will try to tempt us so that we do something that we're not supposed to do, or he'll distract us so that we lose focus, right? We lose track of what we're doing. We forget what we're doing. We start moving priorities around, right? It's like during Thanksgiving, you're totally stuffed. You can't eat anymore. You know that you're going to have to go to the gym and, work off all these calories, but someone busts out a plate of cookies. You're done. Game over. Especially this chocolate chip. Just call it a night. Just eat two. You're done. Game over. You already fell into an extremely high caloric intake. You're going to have to do some more push-ups and sit-ups the following day, right? Or the enemy will tell us lies, right? This is that deception. He'll tell us lies to make us feel like Hawkeye, that we're less than, that we're not as good, we're not as strong, we're not as important as the Thors, the Iron Mans, the Captain Americas, right, of the world. And we can fall into shame and guilt that way. Or he can tell us lies to puff ourselves up so that we feel better about ourselves. We feel invincible. We feel like we can do it, that we're strong enough, we're good enough. And then when we fail, we slip right back into that shame and guilt. And that's how, you know, we end up, you know, missing the mark, because we're not at that level where God wants us to be, because we're drowning in our sorrow and our grief and our shame and our guilt. So what do we do? How do we get over these distractions? How do we get over these deceptions? Well, we have to protect our mind, right? We focus on things that are true, that are noble, that are right, that are pure, holy, admirable, excellent, and praiseworthy, right? This comes from a Bible verse that talks about focusing on these things. If you fill your mind with these things, if you, you know, you're focused on God and His Word, the enemy will have a very hard time distracting you, deceiving you, right? So now that your mind is filled with the things of God, you'll be able to hit the target every single time, right? Because you're doing exactly what God wants you to do. So I want to encourage you guys that yes, you know, we want to hit the target. We want to do good, but we will fail. We're still human. We're still people. So please do not aim for perfection. There's only one person who's perfect. His name is Jesus, right? We're not perfect until we get up to heaven, right? Until we're in our glorified bodies that Jesus promises us. Until then, work towards progress, right? Work towards doing all that you can and leaving the results up to God, all right? God doesn't call us to be perfect or to hit the mark every single time. God wants us to be willing. God wants us to be available. God wants us to put our best effort and rely on Him and allow God to hit the target for you, right? Just like the David and Goliath story, right? David uses a slingshot, flings that rock at Goliath, and the Bible tells us that God was the one who guided the stone that hit Goliath in the forehead. It was God who took care of, you know, of the bullseye, because David trusted God and knew that God was going to help him and that Goliath was no match for how strong God is. So God bless you guys. We'll see you in the next one. All of our links, if you want to follow us on all different social media, is down below. See you guys next time. Peace.